upon your revelation, God. Continue to give these saints ears to hear and a heart to receive. Amen. Amen. Daniel, the 10th chapter. We're going to skip through a couple of verses. The first, second, then we're going to 10 through 14 with the keynote verse being verse 14. In the third year of Cyrus, king of Persia, a thing was revealed unto Daniel, whose name was called Belshazzar, and the thing was true, but the time appointed was long, and he understood the thing and had understanding of the vision. In those days, I, Daniel, was mourning 3 full weeks, and behold, verse 10 says, and hand touched me, which set me upon my knees and upon the palms of my hands. And he said unto me, O Daniel, a man greatly beloved, understand the words that I speak unto thee, and stand upright. For unto thee am I now sent. And when he had spoken this word unto me, I stood trembling. Then said he unto me, fear not, Daniel, for from the first day that thou didst set thine heart to understand and to chasten thyself before thy God, thy words were heard, and I am come for thy words. Remember this thought, I am come for thy words. But the prince of the kingdom of Persia withstood me 120 days. But lo, Michael, somebody said Michael, one of the chief princes came to help me, and I remained. Somebody said I remained there with the kings of Persia. Now I am come to make thee understand what shall befall thy people in the latter days. For yet the vision is for many days. Hallelujah. I'm going to use for a title under this thought tonight. It may be delayed, but it still remains. Hallelujah. I ask you to remember the thought, I have come for thy words. And then the Bible says in conjunction the word, but the prince of the kingdom of Persia withstood me 21 days. But yet the Bible says Michael, the chief priest, came to help me, and I remained there with the kings of Persia. Not one king of Persia, but the Bible says kings of Persia. The Bible talks about how that the angels were fighting for the blessing of Daniel, had prayed up. He was praying. He had prayed and released his prayer, and the thing was held up for 3 full weeks. It had Daniel mourning. And have you ever released a prayer that stood still in time? Hallelujah. But God is giving you a word tonight. He's telling somebody, I have come for your words. Sometimes we think that God has forgotten about us. We think that God has forgotten the prayers that we prayed, the thoughts that are in our heart, the desires after his word that were in our hearts. But the Bible says that God does not forget the cries of the righteous, but he is near to them, hallelujah, that long for his soul. Angels were yet fighting for what Daniel had prayed for, and it didn't look like it to Daniel because he was mourning for a period of a long time. See, there are many of us that has been in a delay between your prayers and your praise report, but there is a prophetic portal that is still going to release the prayers of your blessings, the blessings of your prayer. It may be delayed, but it still remains, because God has your blessing staying put. He is, the Bible says that he is remaining. He is holding back the devil that is holding up your prayers. They haven't come to pass yet. They are ascended. They have ascended, but they have not yet descended from heaven. But just because they have not descended from heaven, that don't mean that God has lost your appetite. That don't mean that God has lost his desire for you. That don't mean that God has lost his love for you. He has not lost the prayers that you have laid up. He has not lost the thoughts that were in your heart. He says, I have come for your words. You have gotten prayers that have ascended, but the results haven't descended. And the enemy has had you questioning your relationship with God. And it has you questioning, hallelujah, well, you've been in right standing with God. But he told Daniel Kaneda, I need you to stand still. I need you to stand upright. I heard your request the first time. I heard your supplication when it was released out of your mouth, when it came from your heart, because you set your heart to understand. I want to speak again. It may have been delayed, but with God, it still remains. There are times when prayers and what we've been praying just get caught up in the air. It has ascended, caught up in the air, and because they have been caught up and have not come back down, you think God has not forgotten, but God has not forgotten. The Bible says that he will never leave you nor will he forsake you, but he will be with you even until the end of the world. God is about to come for your words today. He is about to come for everything that has been laid up in heaven's ear. He has heard our petitions. He remembers the dreams. He remembers your thoughts. He remembers your longings. He remembers the stuff you cried about from 20 years ago. He remembers the time you said, Lord, I don't want to be in the middle of it. I want to be in the right standing of it. And sometimes we have the tests of life that are in the middle of our prayers and our praise report. And the test is what the enemy uses to make us forget that God has not forgotten. And you got to learn how to pass the test in the middle of the test, because if you are not careful, the enemy will make you trip up over your test. But if you can pass the test of time, the Bible says that in due season you shall reap if you faint not. Sometimes we have temptations that are in the middle of our prayers and our praise report, and then sometimes we have too many. Felicia just talked about too many what? Too many voices in our ear, too many negative thoughts in our mind, too many bad seeds in our soul. You got too many that are in the middle of your prayers and your praise report, and thinking not strange that the enemy sent. The Bible says that there was a king of Persia. Now you understand this text. The Bible says that the king of Persia had a opposition with the kingdom of God to oppose God's people. This is why the enemy tries to catch our prayers in heaven. That's why sometimes you can't tell your business too soon. Sometimes you gotta date God in private until he released the blessings publicly, because people will try to sabotage, hallelujah, your miracle, your breakthrough, your blessing, everything that God has decreed for your life. So sometimes you gotta not be like Joseph and tell it all, but hold your peace and let the Lord fight your battle, because tests will get in the way, temptations will get in the middle of it, and then too many people will start speaking against the blessings that God has over your life. And so many of us have been fighting the air, hallelujah, fighting our minds, fighting all the spirits, because of the kings of Persia that have been opposing the blessings that they don't want to see you have. They have been opposing your breakthrough. Not just one king, the Bible says, but many kings, kings of Persia. There are many spirits of wickedness in high places. This is why some of the stuff that we've been praying for has been held up for too long. This is why some of our financial blessings have not been released yet, because the enemy of poverty is trying to hold on, hallelujah, and he'll test you with the test of money. He'll tempt you with the tempt of lust. He will talk to you by too many strange voices in your ear. But if you can fight the times of the air, if you can fight the enemies that are in the atmosphere, if you can fight the demonic oppressions that are trying to oppose the blessings of the Lord, and you can walk through the test and not stop at the test. See, I've been tested and I've stopped and said, Lord, I don't know this answer. And I've had to take the makeup test and I still failed the makeup test. And I had to go back around and take the other test back again. And then temptation to show up and God, I get that thing right. But I didn't pass the first test, so I got to repeat the first formula. And then too many negative voices will be in your ear and say, you are not qualified. You are dismissed. You cannot do what God has called you to do. And the prayers that I've gone up, the prayers that you have gone up will just get caught up in the air. But God is saying, I've come for your word today. I'ma release your word today. I'ma release the answer today. I'ma release my breakthrough today. I'ma release your healing today. I'ma release your deliverance today. I'ma release the miracle today. Everything that has been tied up, everything that has been tangled up, everything that has been retained, God says, I'ma remain. See, there are some enemies that we have to fight, but there are some demons that the Lord himself has to fight. Everything is not equipped for everybody to fight. This is why the Bible says that the demonic spirits, they were fighting the prayers of the righteous, but the Bible says that the Lord stood back, Kamisha, and he says, I'm remaining the king of Persia, because if he don't hold back Lucifer, he will try to take everything that God has already given you. But God has some stuff on hold right now. Why? Because he's holding back the prince of Persia. The Bible says in verse 13 that even though the prince of the kingdom Persia withstood him 1 and 20 days. Pastor was talking about this 21 days just stuck with me. God says, I'm coming for your word, Monique. I'm coming for your word. The Bible says that Michael, one of the chief priests, came to help me. See, sometimes you need some angelic assistance to pull down certain strongholds. Sometimes you got to call, hallelujah, on the name of Jesus. But sometimes you got to touch and agree with the Holy Ghost. See, angels were on assignment to help Daniel in this hour. And God is going to send you some help. He's going to send you the help that you need. For every devil that has fought you in the years before has got to be defeated in this 21st year. But there is something that has to take place. And so the until factor, which declares God coming for your words, has to kick in when God says, I heard you the first time. I heard you the first time call on my name. But until factor says, I had to see you set your heart to understand. Look at somebody and say, it may be delayed, but it still remains. See, the 21-day period of Daniel's prayers being held up and caught up in heaven and in the atmosphere, before heaven could release it, God had already heard and he had already said, I'm coming for your word. But then the Bible says that there was an appointed time that Daniel had to understand what the vision was all about. Sometimes God is not releasing everything because we don't yet have a full understanding of the purpose that God is manifesting for your life. But he has come for your words. It may have been delayed, but it still remains. Angels are holding on to your prayers. You didn't talk to God in vain. The blessing was held up, but you got to hold out. Jacob said, I will not let you go, Lord, until you bless me. Have a will to not let the Lord go and watch God make it remain. Not only will it remain in heaven, but it will be released on earth. At this level, the best thing for anyone to do is what Daniel did. And remember, I talked about that until factor. Until you set your heart to really understand, we wouldn't get tangled up and tied up in the middle of the moments and trust God with the choices of the aftermath. But what you got to do as Daniel did, remember the Bible says Daniel was preferred because an excellent spirit was within him. There was a point in the Bible where there were many that were among Daniel, but they were also too busy to pray. They were also too busy in their personal affairs rather than paying attention to the real affairs of God. And in the Bible, it talks about how that even the others that were with him, at one point in time, they left, they fled. Why? Because God was dealing with Daniel on a particular vision. And some of us have gotten a certain thing that God is dealing with only you about, that only you got the answer to, that only you got the anointing to do, that only you got the wisdom to do. And the enemy is trying his best to delay delay your blessing and to delay the opportunity for God to do and manifest the fullness of his will and his word for you. But God is saying, I am come for your words. You got to pursue God. The Bible says that Daniel pursued God when everybody else was pursuing themselves. Sometimes you got to drop some stuff off. You got to get light for the flight. The Bible says that Daniel, when I read the text, he gave God the very best that he had. He gave it unto God and not unto the stuff that was around him. The Bible says that Daniel was on his face until all of his strength had failed from him. And sometimes you just got to pursue God in areas that others are not pursuing him. Sometimes you got to stay on your face until everything that God has decreed come to pass in your life. Sometimes you got to pursue God while everybody else is hiding from God, while everybody else is trying to get their blessings. Daniel says, I'm trying to get in God's heart. While everybody else is seeking the money and the man, Daniel said, I'm just seeking the heart of God. You got to pursue God. Daniel 10 and 7, and I, Daniel, alone saw the vision. See, God ain't going to talk to everybody about the same vision. For the men that were with me saw not the vision. For the men that were with me saw not the vision, but a great quaking fell upon them. So they fled to hide themselves. The Bible says that Daniel was left alone, but he was still trying to get understanding. So much so until he had no more strength within him. Not only do you have to pursue God, but secondly, you got to please God. Tell somebody, God is coming for your words. See, one thing about the Bible is the Bible says that God hears his word. He hears his word. In the beginning was the word, and was the word was with God. How do you please God? The Bible says by faith we please God. The act of faith from a pure spirit is what pleases God. I've often said prayer without repentance is not pure prayer. And the only way we're going to please God is through a prophetic pure prayer that pleases God, when it's not about what's going on around you, but it's all about what's going on in him. Tell somebody, you got to please God. It may be delayed, but it still remains. See, Daniel was in position, hallelujah, to please only God. And not only please God, but you gotta press for God. Sometimes the press hurts. Sometimes the press don't feel good. Sometimes the press makes you have to encourage yourself. Sometimes the press will keep you on your face. Sometimes the press will make you roll over on your back to God. You'll turn around and you don't know why you're going and why you keep coming, but you'll keep pressing even when it don't make sense, even when it don't feel good, even when it don't sound good. But like the woman with the issue of blood, with all the others that were around her, the Bible says she came in from behind because she was trying to press for a healing that man couldn't give her. She was trying to press for a deliverance that the doctors couldn't find for her. She was trying to press to be whole that she knew she couldn't get from her circle, from her family, from her associates. Why? It's all in the pressing. When Daniel pressed the way that he did, he pleased God in a manner that no other could please him, and all because he pursued God. The Bible says that when his prayer had already gone up, see, the great thing about our God is he knew the heart of Daniel's prayer when the prayer was released from his heart. So it didn't matter what Daniel did after he prayed. God had already heard him from his heart, and because God had heard him from his heart, he answered him in the beginning, even before he manifested in the end. Pastor said it earlier today, you got to see the end even from the beginning, because God says, I will declare your ending even from your beginning. But when we don't look in the end into the beginning, and we look from the beginning to the end, we get stuck in the middle, and we can't get over the test, we can't get over the temptation. But your press gotta pull you so close to Jesus that you don't care, hallelujah, what people are looking like around you, how bad it looks around you, how messed up it looks around you. I'm pressing for the mark of the high calling of God that is in Christ Jesus. I got prayers that have been stored up in heaven. I got a prayer that has been laid up. The Bible says, lay not your treasures up in the earth where moth and the thieves can take it away, but lay your treasures up in heaven. And we've been storing stuff around the feet of the wrong people, but when you lay it up in heaven, when you lay your purity up in heaven, even though it don't seem like God is working it out, even though it don't seem like God is fixing it, I'm telling somebody, he's coming for your words. Everything that the devil has held up and has been retained is about to be released, because God is sending help. He's sending the right help, and he gonna send it right on time. On this third day in this 21st year, I'm declaring a release. I'm declaring a breakthrough. I'm releasing, hallelujah, oh, every blessing that has already been stored up, every praise report to come down in this earth as it's already been laid up in heaven. Because the Bible says, hallelujah, not only that the Lord is our shepherd and we shall not want, he making us to lie down in green pastures. He leading us beside the still waters. He restored our soul. He leading us down the path of righteousness for his namesake. Yea, though you walk through the valleys of the shadow of death, fear no evil. This is what the Bible told Daniel. Don't be afraid of the kings of Persia that you see in your face. Don't be afraid of their faces. Walk and praise them. Press and praise him. Live and praise him. Enjoy, rejoice and praise him. My focus is to pray and to please God and to press for God. I don't have to do anything else but watch God release, because he is remaining the king of Persia, the enemy himself that's trying to hold back the blessings and the favor and the blessing and the miracle from coming to pass. That's why it has not come to pass yet. Because there is a Persian king, a prince of Persia, hallelujah, that's holding it up. But God has come for your words today. Tell somebody, he's come for your words. And I don't care, hallelujah, what little imps are in the way, what test temptations and too many people that are standing in your way. I believe Pastor said the path has been cleared. The way has been made straight. The angels have already been given an assignment to release your blessing, to release what God has already heard. And we know the power of the hand of God, that the purposes of God, who can disannul, who can keep his hand back? What God is blessed, no man can curse. And what God is cursed, no man can bless. The angels are releasing it even now in the atmosphere. Michael is roaring for your blessing and your breakthrough. There is an angel that is on assignment, oh, to detain your devil that's trying to hold you up. Come on, give the Lord a victory hand clap of praise. It was delayed, but it's still in God's remains.